YouTube was good. Chavis Crew was handing. What's the Chavis Crew family? You guys are an extension of that. Back with another video for you guys today. Had to get back in the lab, man. Some very, very dope news just dropped, man. And I think, you know, it's definitely a different style video for me yet again. But I love basketball. I love the NBA, all those types of things. So, you know, that type of news is very important to me, I think. You know, when you think about the NBA and then you think about sneakers, I think they really go hand in hand. Sneakers, fashion, all that, and the NBA, they all go hand in hand. And especially, you know, with everything that I have going on, you know, those are very similar topics, man. But anyway, we're going to jump right into it, man. So first things first, the news that dropped was Steve Nash has now become the head coach of the Brooklyn Nets alongside Kevin Durant and Kyrie Irving. And there were a lot of mixed emotions, mixed feelings, et cetera, et cetera. So here's my take. First of all, I think that this is not a new discussion that they've had. This is, you know, this has been in the works for a while, especially, you know, grabbing KD on board. You know that his opinion was going to be heavy as far as who he wanted to have as the next coach. And I'm pretty sure that was established before he even signed to go to the Brooklyn Nets. So I feel like the players brought it to the attention of the organization, or maybe the organization brought it to the players, but it just makes sense. One of the guys in the organization was a teammate of Steve Nash's in the Phoenix Suns. Steve Nash has also been working alongside of the Golden State Warriors, alongside Kevin Durant, and they win the championship at the Golden State Warriors. He worked closely with Durant. I've seen a lot of different workout footages. They were working out together, and he's built a good rapport with Kevin Durant. And if you know Kevin Durant, you know Kyrie Irving. They are very strongly opinionated. Kevin Durant may not voice his out in the public as much, but you can tell he's a very strong, opinionated person, just like a real person. Like, we all are very opinionated. And then Kyrie Irving is just Kyrie Irving, man. He just does Kyrie Irving. You know, he feels how he feels, and he feels strongly about, you know, what he believes in. And, you know, I can respect that. But at the same time, when you're dealing with those type of people, you have to have someone in place to be able to kind of control their egos, as well as somebody that they can really get along with or somebody that they respect. Shannon Sharp made a good point. I think it was Shannon Sharp earlier today saying that, you know, Michael Jordan needed a coach like Phil Jackson. It wasn't necessarily always about X's and O's. It was about having, like, bringing that ego together to kind of make it work for the team. And he did the same thing with Kobe Bryant and Shaq. You know, so I think that, you know, the Nets have in their mind, first of all, you see Steve Kerr and all the success that he's had just being relatable to players and being able to kind of tame those egos, because he has the respect, he has the knowledge, the IQ, the championship, the player experience that people, you know, that basketball players, especially high level basketball players, respect. It takes a lot to earn someone's respect, who they look at themselves like, I'm one of the best players in the world. You really have to earn that respect. So I think, you know, with somebody like Steve Nash, they're already, you know, pretty cool with, they got a good kind of vibe with already. And build a personal relationship or somewhat of a relationship with, especially with Kevin Durant, you know, and that's the type of guy that you want to have at the helm. It just makes sense for the Brooklyn Nets to have Steve Nash in that position, man. So that's just my opinion. I definitely feel strongly about that. I feel like, you know, when you've already built those relationships, you do get, you know, put in situations like this. When you build relationships, that's why building relationships is so important. But now, on the other hand, what I did not like about when the news came out, I saw a lot of people saying that it was white privilege that got Steve Nash this job. And though I understand where they're coming from, I disagree in this particular situation. I disagree because I feel like it was Kevin Durant and Kyrie Irving choosing someone rather than the organization like, okay, well, we got Steve Nash out there. He's white, so let's choose him. I just don't think that it was like that. I think that the players are the one You know, especially when you get in guys like Kevin Durant, much like LeBron James, you know, it just is what it is. Those guys have a lot of say-so of everything that goes on within that organization, especially when they're signing to a new team. You got to know that Kevin Durant has already talked to them about this before he even signed the deal to go to the Nets. My voice is going to be heard in these situations. When it's a coaching decision, it needs to go through me. When it's a physical trainer, anybody on the staff, it needs to go through me. I'm the guy of this team. I'm the face of this franchise, and everything has to go through me. And if you don't understand that, you really don't understand basketball. You know what I mean? So it's like you really have to understand that side of being a superstar to even grasp what I'm talking about right now. And, you know, truth be told, I understand the climate that we're in, and I understand the point that Stephen A. was trying to make, you know. But in this particular situation, that's not right. And that's not what really happened. That's not what really went down, in my opinion, you know. And I know this is all opinion-based and things of that nature. But, you know, I think that just because we're in this climate, that we can't blame everything now on race. You know, I don't think everything comes down to race. Like, goodness gracious, I just don't understand. You know, I do understand, actually, but I just don't agree with it being like that. I think take the time. I know it was very, very quick. You see the news and ESPN got to get something out there. He got to write up something really quick and kind of boom. It's entertainment. First Take is entertainment. Like, that is entertainment. So I understand that whole climate. But when you start bringing things in about race, you really have to do your homework. You really got to understand and know for sure, or even close to being for sure, that, okay, this is why, this is exactly why it happened. But if the players chose him, if the superstar that everything has to go through chose that coach, that's just like something that LeBron James would do when he got to different teams, when he got back to Cleveland. He wanted Tyronn Lue. They went and got Tyronn Lue. That's just how it works. And I feel like, in my opinion, that Stephen A. should know that. And I feel like, you know, most guys that play basketball, that understand this side of the business, should understand that as well, man. And that's just my take. That's just my thoughts. Y'all let me know. Sound off in the comments below. How y'all think, what do y'all think about Steve Nash becoming the new head coach of the Brooklyn Nets? Me personally, that's my new favorite team. I think I shared this on Facebook just a few minutes ago that, like, dang, man, like, it just doesn't feel the same without having Kobe with the Lakers. I'm naturally a Lakers fan, but when Kobe left, it just doesn't feel the same for me. And Kevin Durant has been my favorite player ever since Kobe left. So that's my guy. That's going to be my team. That's who I'm rocking with. That's who I'm supporting, man. So, you know, like I said, y'all let me know in the comments below how y'all feel about the Steve Nash job, how y'all feel about, you know, it being called, you know, a white privilege thing. Y'all let me know in the comments below. Sound off and let me know what you think. But yeah, man, thank you guys for watching today's video. Y'all already know the vibes. I appreciate y'all. Love y'all. All the support and love that you guys show continuously. I really appreciate it, man. Y'all don't even understand, man. I really appreciate it so much. Thank y'all for all of that, man. We closing in on 900 subscribers, man. We getting there. As soon as we get to that 1,000 subscriber mark, man, I'm going to show y'all my whole collection, the whole vibe. Giveaway, everything, man. So y'all make sure y'all stay tuned. Show love, spread love. Keep sharing this channel. Like, subscribe, comment, all that good stuff, man. Tell a friend to tell a friend to pull up on this channel. Just the beginning of what I'm gonna be bringing here, man. Shout out to y'all yet again. But y'all know the slogan. God is love. God loves you. I love you. Save his crew. I'm out.